Hi guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. This is the next session in Apache Spark Series. Till our last session, we have covered understanding closures. If you have not seen that video, you can find that in I button. And please watch all previous videos in this Apache Spark Series, because in this video, we are following the official documentation of Spark, which will help you understand Spark from very core. So moving on from here, next comes printing RDD elements. I don't think that is much important. We already know all that take, collect. And still, if you have some doubt in this, please watch my other Spark videos. I have covered all of this in those videos. Then comes working with key value pairs. This is not much different from whatever operation we do on Spark. But yes, the function that can be used on a paired RDD are very important to learn. And I'm skipping this section because almost all the transformation and action that you can do on a pair RDD I have already covered in my transformation and action series. So please go ahead and watch that. And if you still have doubt, let me know in the comment section. All this map, filter, flat map, and reduce by key, group by key, the differences between them, I have already covered in my other videos. I'll link them in the description. Please watch that. And if you still have any doubt, let me know. So moving on. Actions, again same, I have covered it. Here they have mentioned Spark RDD API also exposes asynchronous versions of some actions. Yes, this asynchronous action I have not covered in my earlier videos, and this is sort of important when it comes, like many of you ask that how we can improve performance of a Spark application. So these asynchronous actions can help us improve the performance of our application where we have to do multiple tasks, and we have an option if being said our some of the cores we think are underutilized, we can do those operations in parallel. So let us first see what is asynchronous operations. So let's suppose we are doing some transformation on an RDD, let's say. So let's suppose we have kind of two operations. To make it more clear, let's consider we have one requirement to establish a connection between some database or data source. So this is our first operation, that we have a DB and we have to build a connection between our application and that DB. So this is operation number one. The second operation, you can say that we have a huge data lake, and from that we have to get the data. I mean, you can say this is an IO operation, and you have to read a huge amount of data into your system. Okay, this is the operation number two. Let's say you start your application. Now your application first sees that I have to build a connection to database. So it starts building a database connection, and let's say it takes some 20 seconds to build that connection. After that, our requirement is we have to build a database connection, and we have to read some text or do some transformation or actions. And after that, we have to persist that data into this database. This is our requirement, basically. So do you think if this is taking 20 seconds, we need to wait till 20 seconds for it to get this connection established, and then only we can start reading the data? No, right? This data is huge. This might take a couple of hours in reading and doing all that transformation. So let it take 20 seconds or 2 minutes or 20 minutes. We still are wasting that particular amount of time waiting, because we know that after that we have to do anywhere between 1 or 2 hours of operation. But Spark does everything synchronously, that is, in a sequence. First it will do operation 1, then it will go to operation 2. I hope you get the picture. Let me show a practical example to you. So jump cut to code base. This is a very simple example. I have made an RDD by parallelizing a list 1 to 6, and I'm doing nothing, just a simple collect, and on each element I'm doing a println. It's a straightforward example. And similarly, this is kind of redundant, but for the purpose of this video, I'm reading another list and doing exactly same thing on this second RDD. Let me run this. Let me expand this. So here you can see Spark context started, and it did the operation 1 and printed the elements of first RDD. So this is doing it in sequence. First this operation was done, then after this all these Spark logs, and then the second operation was done, correct? So many of you might have not noted this, but we have an option to do this in parallel. Now coming back to this definition, I think now you'll understand more. and also I will explain in my words so that it's easy to understand for you. It exposes asynchronous versions of some actions like for each async for for each, which immediately return a future action to the caller instead of blocking on completion of this action. This can be used to manage or wait for the asynchronous execution of the action. So to understand this, first let me explain you one small word that you might hear once you get into asynchronous operations in the Spark, that is future action. What is future action? They are saying it returns a future action. So what this means is, let's suppose this first operation in our example was this particular small operation, that DB connection which I told. Consider this the first action. Okay, so we'll name this val, let's say slow RDD. How can this be slow? Let's add a small statement. Let's make it sleep for say 2 seconds. So I'll add for every for printing every element, let's make it sleep for 2 seconds. So thread.sleep 2 seconds. Okay, fine. So let's first see now how we are getting our output. You can see here, right? Element 1, every 2 seconds we are getting, but still the second operation is not started because it's waiting. Until unless this operation, the DB connection won't execute, the next operation won't execute. You can see, right? Every 2 seconds we got this operation. This was our DB connection being established, just to make an analogy. But till the time this DB connection didn't establish, we didn't get our other output. So this was basically what I was trying to explain here. Now, what is the solution for this? We can use asynchronous actions. So to code that, this was our slow RDD. Let's name it as our fast RDD. Okay. Now this is our fast RDD because we haven't mentioned any sleep function here. So this will work right away. Now in place of collect, if you use collect async, there are multiple asynchronous actions that Spark provides. Collect async, for each async, as this example told you. For each async, collect async, count async. So we'll see what other options we have once we get to optimization. So in place of collect, let me use collect async. So this is this operation that is slow. So hence we want to use it as asynchronous operation. Let's see what we get now. I'm executing the step after every change so that it will be more clear to you. So let's see what we get. Our second output is as it is. And first we are getting a wrapped array. Okay. One more thing, when you do an async action, it actually doesn't know what is going to come. So it happens in most of the async operations. So to solve this, just another map is needed to map it through this particular wrapped array. So for printing before this, I'll just include one more map, x such that x dot map, and let me do a x and include this particular print statement inside this. Fine, let me execute now. Sorry, let me do async here as well and run it again. Now you can see here you will get the error as cannot call methods on a stopped Spark context. What does this mean? This means, as we know, this collect async is an async action, and what async action returns is a future action. Future action means this collect async action tells the Spark context that after this, whatever comes, I'm not returning you the exact output, but I'm giving you a future action like a ticket or a rain check, that as and when I get the output, because this is a DB call or some other operation that will take time, as and when I will get the output, I'll return that. So this is the future action. And now why we are getting this error? Because here we are expecting a future action, and after all our operation, by default, Spark context is getting terminated. As per the normal Spark application lifecycle, after all the code is finished, the Spark context will get terminated. So what happened when this has to return the future action? We are not, the Spark context itself is not there to get that. So that is why it is saying cannot call method on a stopped Spark context, because here after this particular block, whatever you can say, here the Spark context is terminated. So what we have to do here is, because we are expecting some future action that, okay, whenever all this sleep and all these things get over, just return the print whatever I requested, right? So here we have to use await for the result, await.result, and for what I have to wait, that is our slow RDD. So this is returning a future action. So what this slow RDD will hold, this will hold the future action object, and this await.results accepts the future action object. Hope you get that. So this is a future action object, and I'm passing it through this. And along with this, I need to pass till what time it should wait for this. So as of now, I'm not sure till what time my DB connection will take, or here I can say that 2 seconds into six, but to give an infinite time, let's take duration class, duration dot, let's say infinite. Okay. So await action will take a future action and the duration till what it should wait. That's it. Let me run this. Now here you can see list one was printed, and it printed the second element, and it printed the second RDD. But as we have coded thread.sleep 2 seconds, it had to wait to print the next element. It printed one and passed a future action to the Spark context. So Spark context understood, okay, as and when it will come to 2 for printing, then again sleep 2 seconds, I don't have to wait. I can do whatever else I had to do. It went to the second RDD. Here we didn't have anything to wait, so it printed everything. Following that, every 2 seconds, the first RDD was returning the elements. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we got as and when function was ready to return all those values. So this was a basic idea like how multiple action can be performed asynchronously using the Spark async actions. So I hope I was able to make you understand what is the importance of async actions. But if you still have any doubts, just let me know in the comment section, and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done, and stay tuned to Apache Spark series on GK Code Labs. Thank you guys. See you later.